Oh, hi, Biff.
Hey, Biff.
Hi, guys. Say, Mr. Hanford.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, could you rustle me up a lettuce and tomato sandwich, hold the mayo, and a glass of milk?
Sure, Biff. Hey, Biff, is that your bowling ball?
Yeah. Did you think it was someone else's?
Why are you carrying it around?
Yeah. Well, because it's stuck on my thumb, see?
Oh, no! Are you going to get it taken off?
Well, I could, but I don't want to. I repeat, I do not want to. Yeah, I've decided I'm keeping it on my thumb forever. I like it there. It's a beautiful bowling ball, and I'm lucky it's stuck on my thumb because wearing it makes me happy.
You're happy?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, I'm so happy to have my bowling ball stuck on my thumb. Mwah! Yes, I love you, bowling ball. And now that you're on my hand, I can watch you all the time. Yeah, I'll never lose you. I'll see you each night when I go to beddy bye. You'll be there when I wake up in the morning. My bowling ball. So it stays on, okay?
But you can't keep it on your hand.
And why not?
Because you can't do anything with a bowling ball on your hand.
Charlie's right, Biff.
Oh, yeah? Wrong. I can do anything. Want to see me scratch my nose?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Biff,
are you all right?
Biff, you all right?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. I can do anything, but remind me not to do this. Oh.
Biff!
Oh, no.
I'm all right.
Sometimes it's the way a wave is bubbling at my feet, or the way my baby brother smiles for me. And I know this must be happy, happy happiness. Oh, yes. And sometimes looking at the ocean is enough to curl your toes up. Hey, don't you turn your nose up at that feeling. That feeling you're feeling. Hello, happy happiness. Juicy peaches. Happy, happy, happiness. Well, maybe it's the way a seagull's swooping like a kite, or the way the breeze is blowing sweet and pure. But I know it's for sure. Happy, happy, happiness. Or maybe it's some little nothing like a stone skipped on the water. Everybody ought to know this feeling you're feeling. Hello, happy happiness. Hello, happy happiness. Silly jokes and what comes after. House of everybody's laughter. Happy, happy happiness. Come on. Hello, happy happiness.
Yes, you are.
Happy, happy, happiness. Hello, happy, happiness. Happy, happy, happiness.
This is my dog. His name is Happy. Want to know why I called him Happy? Watch. Here, boy. Want a doggy goody? And that's why I call him Happy.
Robin, our art teacher, had us make a quilt. Do you know what a quilt is? Well,
A quilt to me was like something that you could and like put over your bed, and something that keeps you warm.
It's sort of like cheap, but it's fluffy, and you have pictures or designs on it.
On our quilt, we drew pictures of each other's faces. No, not like that. Like that. We had to really look at each other and see how different faces show different feelings.
I look happy in the picture because, you know, since she was drawing me, the way she drew me was I had a smile on my face, but I'm glad she drew me with a smile anyway.
And she's rocking and she's got all day long, hopping and singing that song. All little birds out the street.
Drawing someone is not always easy, but we tried our best.
She said that she couldn't draw, and she tried. And I like the way she draws me.
We have a lot of different feelings. Sometimes scared. Sometimes proud. Sometimes sad.
I like being drawn by someone and modeling for that person.
Ooh, that's fresh.
Yeah, that's cool.
That's pretty.
Look like me?
Yeah, it does.
Surprise!
And here's your milk. Bon appetit.
Same to you.
Biff's got a bowling ball stuck on one of his hands, and he's going to try to eat a sandwich and milk. But how will he pick them up? A bowling ball has no fingers.
Let's see now. How did I used to do this? I picked up the milk with my right hand, and I picked up the sandwich with my bowling ball hand, my left hand. Let's see. This is harder than you think, picking up a sandwich with a bowling ball. It's highly skilled.
It's also highly impossible.
Oh, nothing is impossible. The impossible just takes longer.
Give it up, Biff.
I don't know the meaning of the word give up. Of course. I should have had the sandwich with this hand. My right hand should have had the sandwich. And my left hand I pick up with the bowling ball the glass of milk, like so.
Whoa!
Hey, come on, Mr. Hanford. Put it down. I almost had it.
No way. You'll spill it with that thing on your hand.
Well, what am I supposed to do, pal? Die of thirst? Eat a dry sandwich?
I know what to do. Hold the sandwich and drink the milk through a straw.
You got it.
Yeah.
Just what I was about to say. Hold the sandwich and drink the milk through a straw. Show you what I mean. I eat the sandwich from this hand, munch, 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 and I drink the milk through a straw. Sip, 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 sip. Yeah, yeah. And then this hand is free for anything.
Like what?
Well, like, I'm eating my sandwich, buzz, 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 a fly comes in the room. Do I worry? Oh, no. Buzz, 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 the fly lands on my nose. Do I panic? No. Munch, 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 I take a bite from the sandwich. Sip, 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 I take a sip from the milk. And with this hand, it's free to swat the fly.
You okay, Biff?
Yeah, but remind me to always swat the fly with the sandwich. I think I lost my appetite.
Bud the bird did travel far. Above the city, below the clouds, Bud the bird did say out loud, I love to fly above, you know, but it's just as fun to go below.
Okay, enough practice. Now, Telly, Telly!
What?
Enough practicing. Now to prove that I can do anything with this bowling ball on. We are about to try what you call your scientific experiment, okay?
Okay.
You start an experiment by asking a question, right? Right. So, our question is, can I, Biff, play the piano as well with this bowling ball on my hand as I used to play without the bowling ball? I don't know the answer. Do you know the answer?
No, I can only guess.
Right. So that is why you do an experiment to find out the answer. You've heard me play before without the bowling ball on my hand, right, Telly?
Oh, yeah.
So, here's the plan. I'm going to play with this bowling ball on my hand. Your job is to listen. When I finish, you'll tell me if it sounds as good as when I played it without the bowling ball. Got that?
Yeah.
You ready to hear me play?
Yep.
Hey, how can you listen? You got your hands over your ears.
Huh? Right.
Okay. Here it is, my toughest piece, the first concerto by Tchaikovsky for piano and orchestra and bowling ball. Okay, hit the tape, maestro, and stand back. All right, this is beautiful.
Oh, yeah.
It's coming up to my part. Here we go. Get ready. What do you say, Kelly? Pretty good, huh?
Well...
And not so good, huh?
Well, yes.
But here's the big question. isn't as good as I used to play without the bowling ball.
Yes!
Eureka! Success! We did the experiment. We got the answer. I can play the piano as well with the bowling ball as without the bowling ball. Yes! Maybe we ought to call a piano tuner.
1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, count them up, count them up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, count them up, count them up. 5, 6, where is 7 and 8? 7, 8, 9 and 10, why you call them numbers? What? This is the way we count and sing, what? I saw we count and sing. This is the way we count and sing, what? I saw we count and sing. 1, 2, 3 and 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, them now here. 9, 10, we reach the end. 11, can't wait till we come again.
When you were a baby, you were so very sweet, cooing and a crying and playing with your feet. But now you are a big kid, and look what you can do now. You can skip down the path with the wind in your hair. You can pedal your bike past the old stone bear. You can feed your pet and make it so merry. You can fix a snack of yogurt and berries. You can draw fantastic birds with colors so bright. You can brush your teeth in the morning and night. You can name the dinosaurs that roamed the earth long ago. You can write your name with letters that you know. You're a big kid now. Think of all that you can do. Each and every day, you're doing something new.
Look at this, number 2. Ooh, it is magnificent from any angle.
Thank you for admiring it.
Oh, this number 2 belongs to you?
Yes, it's been in my family for years. You see, I am Lady 2.
Count Von Count. And this is the most beautiful two I have ever seen. And I have seen a lot of twos in my travels.
Yes, I can see that you are a man of the world. Would you like to share this two with me?
To share this two with you?
Yes, we can both enjoy it. After all, it is a number 2. And there are 2 of us, yes?
Yes, I think I know what you mean. This 2 is a 2 for 2.
2 for 2, that's me and that's you.
1 and 1, together we make 2.
And sharing this 2 with you makes me feel brand new. Shall we do a little 2-step?
Charmed.
1 and a 2, and a 1 and a 2.
I do love this 2.
I love this 2, too. We'll count and we'll dance till it's time to say toodaloo.
And when we are through, we'll remember this 2.
This 2 for me, this 2 for you. It's true, this 2's a lovely 2 for 2. I enjoyed our little duet.
Oh, you're too kind.
It's true, this 2's a lovely 2 for 2.
Ah, may we do this again sometime?
How about Tuesday?
Ah, Tuesday. It's a date.
Ah.
2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 Biff, you've got to get that taken off before you break something else.
Hey, accidents will happen. The ball stays on.
Take it off, Biff.
On.
Off!
Stop! Be still, my heart. It's Celeste, my wife, back from work. She'll be on my side. She'll want me to keep this bowling ball on.
Hey, honey, I'm home.
Oh, Hanford, Telly, this is the missus, my better half, also known as my wife, Celeste.
Pleased to meet your acquaintance.
She's in education. She stops cars so school kids can cross the street. Show them what you do, Celeste.
Okay. Stop!
We're talking major talent. Ah. Bravo, sweetie.
Ah, thank you, lover. Take off the bowling ball.
You too?
Hun, you can't do nothing with a bowling ball on your hand.
I ate a sandwich and milk.
And you conked yourself on the head and nose.
I played the piano.
And you broke the piano.
Take it off, honey. I'll call Dr. Edwin.
No.
Who's Dr. Edwin?
He takes bowling balls off your hand.
No, forget Dr. Edwin. I'm not taking off this bowling ball.
Why?
Because a man's got to do what a man's got to do, and I'm afraid of the doctor.
So that's why he wants to keep it on.
Hey, funny lammy pie. Let the doctor take the ball off. Doesn't hurt. I had mine taken off, remember?
Take it off, Biff.
Yeah.
Give me one good reason.
Okay. Okay. Do you like it when we hold hands, baby lamb?
You know I do, sweetie. Yeah. I love it when we hold hands. Our fingers are all mixed up together and it feels warm. And I'd rather hold your hand than anything. Even pizza.
And which is the hand I always hold? Let's hold hands now. What do you feel?
Nothing. I don't feel anything. I don't feel fingers or warmness. What's wrong?
You got a bowling ball on your hand!
Do you feel anything?
Yeah. I feel something round and cold and slippery and not romantic. A bowling ball! I don't want to hold a bowling ball, Biff! If I hold hands, I want to hold a hand!
But, sweetie, it's stuck on my hand. What can I do?
Call Dr. Edwin!
Oh, okay. Call Dr. Edwin.
I'll call him.
No. You stay with me. Please, until he takes it off. Please.
Oh, sure thing, lover.
I'll call him.
Until he comes, will you hold my hand? My bowling ball?
Okay. It's all right. It's all right.
Will it hurt when he takes it off?
It didn't hurt when I had it done.
If I'm brave, will he give me a lollipop?
Hey, honey, I'm not a doctor. Oh, sweetie. Oh.
Do you know what it's like to be scared?
Not me. I'm not scared of anything.
It's just me. Don't be scared.
Far out.
Hi. I'm Maria from the fix-it shop. You called me?
Yeah, come in quick. I got a real emergency here.
What's the problem?
I'll tell you. you what the problem is. Can't get in the dresser to get my socks, cause it's cerrado.
Cerrado.
Can't wear my shoes cause they're in that box, and it's cerrado.
Cerrado.
Can't get my shirt, it's in that drawer. Can't get my pants, they're behind that door. Can't get any new ones from the clothing store, cause it's cerrado.
Cerrado.
Can't reach in the cage to pet my bunny, it's cerrado.
Cerrado.
Can't go to the bank to get my money, it's cerrado.
Cerrado.
Can't get into this case to get my guitar. Can't get into the cupboard for a candy bar. Can't get chili peppers from the pepper jar, cause it's cerrado.
Cerrado.
It's horrible. Cerrado is much, much worse than I suppose.
Cerrado is the Spanish word for closed.
Can't get into that sack to get a potato, it's cerrado.
Cerrado.
Can't get into the fridge to get a tomato, it's cerrado.
Cerrado.
Can't get into the oven to get my roast. Can't get bread from the bread box to make my toast. Yes, the Spanish word that I hate the most is cerrado.
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 I hate cerrado.
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 Cerrado. See, my life's a mess. I can't do anything. Everything is cerrado.
Yes, I see that. Everything is closed.
Yes, yeah, can you help me? Please, can you fix it?
Well, of course I can. What you need is this.
Abierto?
Yes, certainly. Abierto is the Spanish word for open. Abierto.
Cerrado. Abierto. Cerrado. Abierto. Cerrado. Abierto. Cerrado. Abierto. Cerrado. Abierto. Cerrado.
Cerrado.
Oh no! What do I do now?
Hello?
Oh, thanks for coming back. I have another problem.
Another problem?
Yeah.
What is it this time?
Look, everything is all abierto. Can't get my window to keep out the snow, cause it's abierto.
Abierto.
Can't keep warm when the cold wind blows. My coat's abierto.
Abierto.
Folks keep arriving, I don't know whom. All day long, they come into my room. They go to the closet and they take my broom. My door's abierto.
Abierto.
It's horrible. Oh. Can't put this book back on the shelf, cause it's abierto.
Abierto.
Can't chew my food, can't feed myself. My mouth's abierto.
Abierto.
My chickens ran away without a peep. My horse was something I couldn't keep. The same can be said for my flock of sheep. My barn's abierto.
Abierto.
It's horrible. Can you help me out, fellas? Abierto is the word that's got me moping.
Abierto is the Spanish word for open.
My eyes never let me sleep at night. They stay abierto.
Abierto.
My hamper can't keep my dirty laundry out of sight, cause it's abierto.
Abierto.
My milk all went sour and my cheese my fridge is abierto, and that makes me mad, cause it's abierto.
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 I hate abierto.
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 Abierto. You see my problem? Everything's abierto.
Yes, I can see that. Everything is open.
Yeah, can you fix it? Huh?
I think I can fix this situation.
Oh, good, good, good. You're a genius.
Sure. What you need is this.
Cerrado?
Cerrado. Everything is abierto, which is the Spanish word for open. And this is cerrado, which is the Spanish word for closed. Cerrado.
Wow, unreal. Cerrado, you're the best fixer in the whole world.
Sure, nothing to it. Glad to help.
Hey, want to see something about cowboys? It's in Spanish.
I won't understand it.
Just watch.
Buckaroo. Corral. Lasso. Bronco. Rodeo.
How'd you like it?
Pretty short story. And I thought it was going to be in Spanish.
It was. All those words. Buckaroo. Corral. Lasso, bronco, rodeo, they're all Spanish words.
Really?
Really.
Wow.
Hola, this is your old buddy Big Bird, here in Union City, New Jersey, where most people speak both English and Spanish.
Sabor!
Even a lot of the shop signs are in Spanish. In case you're wondering what I'm doing here, well, I'm here to play with some friends who are going to teach me some Cuban games. And guess what? We're going to do it in Spanish. Look, that's New York City across the river. Oh, and there's my friend's teacher, Margarita. She used to play these games when she was little, too.
Asalto, asalto,
ay, qué lindo, bello. Bello, bello, bello. Vayan a jugar, vayan a jugar, vayan a jugar.
Okay, I'm ready. What are we playing?
It is called El Animo, Big Bird.
El Animo? Gee, I wonder what that's like. El Animo kind of reminded me of London Bridge. Only I was a little too big to go under this bridge. I think I'm too big. Now we're going to play a game called El Trencito. That means little train in Spanish. Hey, wait up, train. Don't leave without me. Not only went choo-choo, but we also pretended there was a cat in it that went meow. And a dog that went how-how. That's arf-arf in Spanish. Well, I guess it's time for your old birdie buddy Big Bird in New Jersey to say hasta la vista.
Yes, yes, yes. Now, Biff.
Yes, Dr. Edwin.
The operation I'm about to perform on you is called a bowlectomy.
Bowlectomy? What does that mean?
Pulling a thumb out of a bowling ball. It's an intricate surgical procedure. But I can't do it alone. No, no, no. You will have to help. We have to cooperate. When I pull, you have to pull too.
Gotcha.
Any questions?
When you pull my thumb out, will it hurt? Yeah.
No.
Well, how do you know?
Well, I've done this same surgical procedure thousands of times, here and in Vienna.
He's a specialist, honey.
Okay.
Well, are you ready now, Biff?
Yeah.
Here goes.
Wait.
What?
Celeste?
I'm right here, hon, right here.
Okay, Biff, here we go. Yeah. Get ready.
Wait.
What?
If I'm brave, do I really get a lolly?
Yes, of course you do.
All right, then.
Okay, now remember, Biff, to cooperate. Mm-hmm. You pull one way, and I pull the other. Mm. Ready? Here we go.
Ow!
Wait. Huh? We haven't even started yet.
Oh.
Ready, set, go!
I'm free!
It's off!
And it didn't hurt a bit!
No.
I was never really afraid!
Oh, you!
Thanks, Doc. I want to shake your hand.
Yes, what? Oh, no! Oh, no! Now it's on my hand! Is there a doctor in the house?
No.
we are holding hands again.
Biff, I would rather hold your hand than hold a bowling ball any day.
Celeste, I'd rather hold your hand than an electric drill.
I ain't holding hands, great.
Fabulous.
On a bright and sunny day,
when you're walking next to me,
and your hand is holding mine,
I'm as happy as can be.
There's a feeling from my fingers as we stroll the avenue,
that you're with me,
and you're with me,
and I'm with you,
and I'm with you.
Ain't it the truth?
Oh, I like to hold a saw,
or a whistle I can blow,
but I love to hold your hand. It's the greatest thing I know, and I think I found a reason that it makes me feel so fine.
Whenever I hold your hand,
whenever I hold your hand, it's holding mine.
Holding hands, a great way to travel.
You can say that again.
Holding hands, a great way to travel.
Oh, I'd like to dig a hole,
help a kid across the street,
but I love to hold your hand, cause it makes my day complete. And I think I know the reason, it's my favorite thing to do. Whenever I hold your hand,
whenever I hold your hand,
whenever I hold your hand, I am with you,
with you,
with you,
with you,
with you.
Ah, pretty nice, huh?
Oh, fabulous. Where do you want to go, lover?
Oh, how about bowling, sweetie?
Ah, that's a great idea. You're so romantic.
Oh. How I Found Love, a true story by Fluffy Simpson. I was young then, just a puppy. Had no place to call home, really. Just roaming the streets with no place to go. You know, a scrap of food here, an old bone there. All alone, nobody loved me. My only company was a large family of fleas. Then one day, a man in a huge white truck took me to a place he called a pound. Boy, I was scared, but the food was real good. At least I was warm. And one day, I looked up and there he was. Petey Simpson. It was love at first sight.
Hello, Puppy Wappy,
he said. I said, and we both knew we were made for each other. After my very first bath, Petey said,
I think I'm going to call you Fluffy and love you forever and ever and ever.
Which means, I love you, too.
Christopher?
Yes?
What does love mean?
Well, see, if you're loving somebody, you have to, let me see, if you love somebody, you kiss them.
Mm-hmm. And what else?
And that means love. Hug, like hugging.
And who do you love?
I love Big Bird, too.
Oh, you love birds and monsters. Can you love people, too?
Oh, yes.
What kind of people can you love?
Any kind.
Sisters?
Yeah, I don't have any sisters.
Brothers?
I don't have no brothers.
Mommy and daddies?
Yes.
Even if you do not have sisters and brothers, can you love them?
Yes.
And teachers?
Yes.
Anybody?
Yes.
Little doggies?
Oh, yes.
Little bunny rabbits?
Yes.
Blue furry monsters?
Yes.
The blue furry monsters are the kind of love I like best.
Oh.
H. H.
H.
H.
H.
Has anybody seen my H?
Heroes.
H.
Hardware.
H.
Hotel.
H.
hairstyles.
H. High school.
H. Hats. H.
Hamburger.
H.
H, 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 H.
H. H. The letter H.
When you're down and you've got the blues and everything is just bad news, just bad news.
Yes, indeed. You make a classic soda, Hanford.
Well, thank you, Biff.
Now we gotta go see Dr. Edwin.
Again?
Yeah, again. He wanted to go bowling.
Yeah, it's like you fall off a tricycle, you should get right back on.
Let's go.
Okay, now. Now, don't be afraid. It doesn't hurt. And you get a lolly.
I know that. And we can hold hands again, right?
I kind of like holding this bowling ball.
Hey!
Oh, only kidding. Only kidding.
Oh, you!
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters H and V and the number 2. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
Funding for this program is provided in part by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting, and by public television stations and their contributors.